What is going on, guys? Wiser here, coming to you with the recaps of some of the most recent wars for 2.0. It was just a couple random clans. First one was an Australian clan. Second one, I believe, was a Colombian clan. Going to combine a couple recaps here now. Of course, since I started doing this, right, generally there's like four or five attacks I like to show from each war, but these wars, you'll see what I'm talking about here in a minute. So this first one, level 10 Australian clan, 83 to 60. They gave it their best, mostly two-star heroes in there. Now, as you can see, even Tiger there is a Town Hall 10. We got a lot of Town Hall 10s now, guys, and it's really starting to show. You know, for a long time, I have been talking about how a lot of guys in our clan are going up to 10. They're all new. They're all working on stuff, and it's starting to shine through because we're getting this whole recap. I think I have 4, 8, 12, like 13 attacks I want to show you here, and they are all at the Town Hall 11 and 10 level. Now, obviously, a lot of these are more like practice-style bases. These aren't bases where you're going to see in a range wars, but really good practice bases nonetheless, right? Upgraded Infernos, a lot of upgraded defenses in there. Some of them rush, some of them not, but I have a ton of attacks I want to show, so just real quickly, check it out. Did miss a 9 there, which is fairly uncharacteristic, but kind of had our way with the top as well, so was no big deal. I am going to just jump right in here. Start at number 11. Burt Dog, brand new Town Hall 10. So you can see only level 32 Queen, 30 King. Brings those Max Valks. Little bit of a Queen charge here. So he's just going to walk right into this section of base. Realizes he's going to continue kind of down here and wants to get in at this Inferno Tower. It gets in at this defensive queen. Now, you're going to see kind of how sometimes, you know, if this were my queen, I definitely would have died. But for everyone else that doesn't seem to have the queen walk problems like I do, just works out just perfectly for Bert. Queen's going to step up in here now. And is just now in Inferno range. So drops that rage to rip through these buildings. Free spell goes down right on that queen. Look at that. Oh, cannot believe my queen would have been dead. I'm sorry. But now is locked right onto that defensive queen. Right on that Inferno Tower. Down it goes. Perfect timing. Almost lost it again there. But absolutely just rips through that section of the base. The whole attack hinged on the success of what just happened. And it was successful. So in come these giants from this kind of 2 o'clock spot. Couple wizards helping create the funnel with the only two buildings on the outside. Like that. So in comes the Valk parade. Look at these Valks, all these redheads going in. King's gonna follow up behind. The idea here, right, is poison up that CC. I don't know if Bert knew what was in the CC, but that would make sense because he's got the double poison there taking care of everything. But the idea is to get the Valks in on top of that Inferno Tower as soon as possible and then heal them afterwards, because here comes that heal spell, going to take care of them. They're going to walk into that core, get all those Teslas, take down that Town Hall, and has a few hogs he's kind of sprinkling in from the other sides of the base. Hogs are going to work through these defenses like nothing. Valks are in there still doing work. King's in there, finally hits the ability to knock down that wall. All these Valks go down. They're going to finish off these bottom compartments here. Just beautiful. Fast forward that because it's basically cleanup. Has that Expo Arch Tower mortar to go. Not Arch Tower on the bottom there. Bam, bam, bam. It's a sexy tree in the bag for Bert Dog. Welcome to Town Hall 10, my friend. I think Bert is our newest, or at least one of our newest, if not our newest Town Hall 10. So, next, number 10, Justin. Another brand new Town Hall 10. I think Justin went up maybe 3 weeks ago. Definitely, you know, within the last 3 to 4 weeks, he's gone up. So, he's only level 34 Queen. Does have those Max Valks in there. So same sort of idea as Bert Dog, right? He's going to just kind of walk into this section of base, start taking out all this jazz. Does have two heal spells in the bag here, which I thought was interesting. So he's only opting for the one jump spell. Pulls out that CC, doesn't quite get all of it, I don't think. So only one witch comes out there, but no big deal. Has the double poison, doesn't use it yet. Has to hit the queen ability there, though. That was probably a little unfortunate. Down goes the one poison just to help things out. Excuse me. Finally, that witch goes down. Queen's going to work her way up the rest of this base. Continue just to take all of this stuff out. Has no worries of stepping into Inferno Tower range. Probably at this point could just start the attack, right? Once that CC gets pulled out, you can send it. Here it comes. Giants in on this top section, literally one building on the outside. Like I said, guys, not the greatest bases, but really nice practice bases for us. There are, you know, level two infernos there. A lot of Town Hall 9 defenses on this base, but you'll see as I go up in the map and go on to the next war what I'm talking about. So Valks are all in, right? I love how the Valks opt to go here to the wall instead of down here to the open area and the jump, but whatever, it kind of works out because he's got this little Valk escort for his king with a wizard in behind kind of doing work as well. They're going to shred through everything. Finally, a bunch of Valks get into the core. Really just needed to get to that Inferno Tower. Finally gets over there with the Valk. So both Inferno Towers are down, has a heal spell left, drops it for the Hogs over on this section because there's really only this little clump of defenses. Queen's going to take care of that last cannon over there, no problem. And everything is going to just continue on through the last four or five defenses he's got here. One more heal spell goes down, keeping the Hogs up through that bomb. Absolutely perfect timing on that, Justin. Okay, kitty, I know. I got a cat trying to get my face here. Anyhow, Justin, again, two to you. Welcome, Town Hall 10, buddy. Glad to have you because it looks like you're really getting your attacks on point here. That is sexy tree in the bag for Justin K. And moving up a bit here, number seven, good old DI, or 2.0 War General, showing us how it's done. Brings four earthquakes, two heals, two rages. Like the earlier earthquake on here, just going to open up huge chunk of this base. I'm kind of interested, DI, if you had meant to leave this wall up here. I don't know. It's a good question. Anyhow, so yanks that CC out right away, pulls it out to the queen instantly. TI actually goes really close as well. I love this little mofo-esque wizard helping out with that hound. Really like that. Queen's going to get through that. That bomb drop almost takes it. Look at this. Boom. Gets so low. Oh, has to hit the ability, but gets through it like nothing. Wizard's helping out. Archer's in there helping out. So probably didn't want to have to use the ability there, but like I've mentioned in videos before, if it comes down to losing your queen, it's obviously way better to hit your ability and keep her going. Little bit off on the rage spell there too. A little scary moment there. I think those giants kind of threw him off because they were supposed to go raid in the base and that Tesla pop. Anyhow, defensive king is now dead. Raid still affecting that queen. She's going to get big value. Continue to work through that stuff. All the giants in. Valks are in under rage. And then I like the hog deployment here. He's like, you know what? I'm just going to one finger this, send it in on this side. And because the Valks are just hollowing out this core, the Hogs are just going to go in a counterclockwise motion around the base. Drops a heal spell, helps them out. Going to continue to work through all this stuff. Has all these Valks in. There's no threat of Inferno Towers anymore. Queen is down there, right? Going to start beating through that wall, but has the healers on her. So she's going to continue to get good value because there is nothing to debug her for the rest of this base. Lose a few Hogs to the Spring Traps, but they're going to continue to do work, kind of get through these next few defenses, leaving just enough time for this Queen to get through everything here. Hogs to catch up, couple more Valks to catch up. Da-da-da. Pogs end up pittering out on this last cannon archer, but like I said, with that queen with the healers under there, there's nothing that that this stuff can do to take her down. So she's just going to continue to walk through the rest of this base. It's like a minute to go of this replay, but obviously you can tell this base is GG. Might have been close on time for this one. Maybe not. He didn't spend a lot of time with the walk. I don't know. Nice hit, DI. Tree in the bag, my friend. Seems like you get one every war now, so really like your progress. All right, number six, Ice Man. 10 versus sort of 10.5. No Eagle Cannon for this guy, but a level 11 Grand Warden in there. Otherwise, I think all Town Hall 10 defenses, max Town Hall 10, yep. So other than this guy's walls had max Town Hall 10 going on and now has dropped it. So he's got the Grand Warden in there. Don't think he has the extra expo. So it looks like he doesn't have any of the Town Hall 11 defenses, just the Grand Warden there. So pure 10.5 here. Look at the Valk Parade coming in. Like the balloons early on, getting the Giants funneled right into that core. They're tanking all those Inferno Towers. All those Valks are going to get in there. Now, a little bit of concern with this. I literally just had a 90% two-star on my Town Hall 10 because my queen ended up doing just what happened with Ice here. And the dragon got out of the poison And the drag just wreaked havoc, just like this, taking out all my Valkyries. So that is always a bit of concern when that you have that deep, deep CC. If you cannot take down the dragon with the poisons, it can pose a big threat, because look how fast these Valks are going to go down. Boom. Sorry, see you later, Valks. But fortunately, the dragon gets over to the queen. The queen followed the hogs, followed the king. So things work out just fine here for Iceman. Hogs are now all in on this very compact, huge compartment. They're just going to continue to work through. Still has one more heal spell for them. Drink this crappy coffee my wife bought. I don't know why she bought it. We buy the same coffee all the time, but, or I should say, I buy the same. I do the grocery shopping most of the time. I'm the chef of the family, obviously. However, occasionally when she goes grocery shopping, I don't understand it. Because she buys things that we never buy and never eat. She buys certain little weird no-name things that I don't know. I try and teach her. I really do. Anyhow, the hogs are going to continue to work through this stuff. He's burnt that heal, so the hogs are going to pit her out here by the end. But realistically, they get through this cannon, I believe, just in time. And then there's just that Tesla left over for the queen to deal with. He's got these wizards down here doing the cleanup for this bottom section. Still has the ability on the queen. So just needs to work her up and around through these army camps. Oh, the hogs didn't even pit her out on that. Nice. I thought the hogs pit her out on that Tesla. But he's got two hogs to go. They're going to help with cleanup. Got to rage up that queen. There it is. Treat in the bag for the Iceman. Hey. Alrighty, so good war 2.0 really showed these Australian guys what the hive is all about. So real quickly, let's take a little trip back through time. All right, so let's take a look at our warlock here. So just had that heartbreaker against War and Glory. Just had that sort of mismatch against the honorable Dark Knights that really handed us our ass with their TH advantage. Dark Looters, the same thing. Exactly the same thing. Anyhow, so let's continue down here. A big win against WHF. I like that one. We went through a very difficult period. Because if you stop the warlock right there, yep. Crystal Warrior was the first one. We lost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of 12. Now, obviously, Crystal Warrior, WHF, Emphatic Fury, Dark Knights, Immortal Thieves, War and Glory, Purbach, Made in Iraq, Modern Clan, Dark Looters, again, like, man, Dark Looters and Dark Knights just have our number. And the Lost. So, this was a really tough period. And when we were going through this, I was talking about how we as a clan are progressing up to Town Hall 10. We got a lot of new Town Hall 10s. We got guys learning the new strats, learning everything, right? And we struggled at first. Like granted, right? Like, this was almost 3 months ago when this Crystal Warrior match happened. And we went through this. So we've had now 3 months more of practice at Town Hall 10. And yes, don't get me wrong, the new Max Valkyries really help out. I'm not going to lie. But again, I think a lot of our guys are getting a lot more comfortable attacking bases with Infernos, breaking them down, you know, really, really transferring their skill from Town Hall 9 and learning to 3-star Town Hall 10s. Because this war, again, same fair, a few rush bases in there, but we had some, just our guys at the top just went off. Like, these are all Town Hall 10s. 10, 10, I think 14's a 9. Yeah, so 10, 10, 10, 10. And Justin, Tiger are brand new, you know? Like, so anyhow, point being, really nice to see after a few months of hard work by these guys at Town Hall 10 that it's really starting to come around. And, you know, I think it's really starting to show, and we're really going to start putting up some seriously nice numbers in our ranged wars because the practice is showing, and it's definitely evident. So let's just jump right in and check out these because I got a lot from this war. Start off with Justin's hit on number 13 here. So this is what I'm talking about. So this is the bottom Town Hall 10, right? So he's got the purple and pink walls, right? Level 2 Infernos, pretty much Town Hall 8 and 9 defenses. So nothing special. But for a brand new Town Hall 10, this isn't easy. This isn't just an automatic 3-star by any means. So, you know, like the level 10 heroes obviously make it a little bit easier. But you still got to break the base down. You still got to figure out how to take care of those infernos without losing too many units. Like, there's a whole, it's a whole new niche of an attack, right? So Justin goes in here, really nice little rage placement, going to get really good value, steps right into this compartment, just going to take care of all the stuff in a horseshoe around this compartment. CC is dead, pulled out to the queen. So in comes the giant, a little giant parade there. Valks are going to follow in behind, going to drop the jump spell right over to that inferno tower. Down it goes. Everything's going to get sucked onto that queen and then finish off that inferno tower. So inferno tower number one is dead. Raid spell goes down. Going to push. Once this stuff goes down, Valks are going to go back up and then up and into that core. Does have a few wander, but no big deal. Gets enough into the core to get on over to that inferno tower. Giants are in helping. Down goes the expo. And, oh yeah, this inferno tower actually doesn't go down. I believe the queen and king get it at the end. Because here come the hogs. They're under the heel. They're okay until they get about over to here. Because see this inferno lock on now? Is that a single target inferno? Yeah, it is. So single target inferno, not a big deal for the hogs, but it does end up making them pitter out, I believe. Maybe not. I saw so many Town Hall 10 attacks today, guys, so my apologies. No, I'm right. So the pogs pitter out there. There's like two left on the end there. But the queen is about to step up. Now, sort of lucky because those single target infernos can really do damage to a queen, but gets it down just in time. Two hogs remaining. Has a few Valkyries up here doing cleanup. Wizards up there helping out. Has a pup kind of chasing around. Wizard's about to take care of that. Poison spell goes down too. May as well drop it. Has a swag poison. Swag king ability because this base is done for. Tree in the bag, Justin K. Nice job, buddy. Phil Moss. QC. Oh, I love this lady. She is just fantastic member of our clan. Nice to see her putting some triples up on the board because I did miss having you in my recaps on a regular basis when you were Town Hall 9. But it's coming, as we can see. You know, Town Hall 10 is really starting to do some damage, really starting to get some good base breakdowns. Again, you know, very Town Hall 9-esque base defense. I think that's only level 2 Infernos. I still don't know the difference. I think that's level 2. Maybe I'm wrong. Whatever. Pretty much, and then there's a level 4 expo in there, and it's kind of interesting, but you can see what I mean. Like, pretty much all Town Hall 9 defenses, a lot of pink purple walls in there, so nothing crazy, but again, this is not easy to do, guys. So little queen walks, you got all this stuff here, gonna continue to work her way down this section of base and down and around. Really just clearing a bunch of percentage. I believe sends in the kill squad from here. Get right into that core, because we'll find out in a second. Oh, no. So meets it up here. Oh, yeah, that's right. Funnel created on the army camps on the other side. Giants are in. Couple wizards down, helping things out. Giants break through. Jump spell goes down. Going to work right into that queen, and here comes a bunch of Valkyries. What I liked about QC's attack here was the 11 balloons, right? Recognize, you know, standard Town Hall 9 practice. You got 3 air defense in the core. Well, if I get a bunch of Valks in the core, that means boom, I can just target balloons on all these outer defenses and they don't stand a chance. Haste spell even goes down to push these loons right in and through all these defenses. 2 more loons on that back end. Archer tower has a rage in the bag that realistically is all swag. Hasn't touched the hero abilities yet. Just smashed this base, QC. Good old swag goblin. Love it. Boom. Swagging it. QC. Tree in the bag. Very nice, girl. Very nice. Tiger. Tiger uppercut. All right. So, another Town Hall 9 base with Inferno Towers. No big deal, though. Tiger's going to go on in here. Think he really wanted to get that army camp dead with that minion. Unfortunately, a bunch of air skeletons come flying out, and that isn't going to happen. So just goes ahead and starts create his funnel with that wizard. Gets that, as long as he gets that gold collector down, it's not going to be a big deal. King, everything's going to go right into this core. Jump right on top of this inferno tower, this single target inferno tower. Isn't doing much to this stuff, especially once you got a bunch of Valks coming in. Guys, especially with the way... with the way Valks are right now at Town Hall 10, I can never see a use for a single target Inferno. I don't know. I think that's something they need to look at. I kind of like having one on my farming base Because you know you're going to see a lot of super queens trying to get in there, and when a single target Inferno locks onto a super queen, she dies real quickly. Other than that, though, in war, Valkyries are so powerful right now. Single target Infernos are just going to get eaten alive by them. So I cannot see a use for them in war. Just as a side note, maybe if someone does have a use for them in war, please leave it in the comments. Always interested to hear you guys' comments. Love chatting with you guys about this stuff because by no means am I right about everything I talk about. In fact, I'm quite wrong sometimes about things I say. So please point it out. I love discussing stuff like that. But as you can see, all defenses are down. Tiger is going to nail this 3-star. Had tons of hogs left doing cleanup. Queen's in there helping out. Cleanup whiz on the other side. Even the old little archers there working on that DE storage. Treat in the bag for Tiger. Tiger. All right. What else? What else? What else? Number 10, Endless. So, Endless. Going in and just going to beast this base. Drops a few archers on these builder's huts on the outside. Drops this queen down. And do a little bit of a walk here. Opens things up. Just kind of opens that outer compartment so she has access to all these buildings right here. So just got to work through that lava hound. Got that. I thought that was a really good idea because if you look at where she's standing, if he did not get that storage down, there is a good chance, especially if a pup was over here and she got yanked another step to the left, she would have went this way. He does want her to go down and into this compartment here, which is exactly what's going to happen. Just going to work through this stuff, make her way in. Right, so CC's taken care of. Queen's going to continue to mop all this stuff up. Is about to send in the rest of his attack. This very ring style base is again very susceptible to Valks, guys. You gotta look at what the strongest Town Hall 10 attack is right now, and it is clearly these max Valks mixed with some form of Queen Walk, Queen Charge. Even just like a shattered entry with some giants. There's so many variations of it, but it's the most powerful thing. People just need to funnel Valks into your core, get them at your Inferno Towers, and you're in big trouble. So in come these giants, just like I had mentioned, in come the Valks, right? Ton of them are going to move right into this base, jump right in basically on top of this Inferno Tower instantly. King goes in behind. Got a wizard in there kind of helping work on the outside. Queen is now in the base helping out. Just kind of perfect timing on everything. Loses a Valk to the Spring Trap. Bam, bam, bam. Valk's moving through everything. Everything just needs to get to this last Inferno Tower up at the top here. Work through that defensive king. And it's going to lock onto that Inferno Tower once all this stuff goes down. Has to get that Town Hall down. Still has the ability, though. Going to burn it just in time. Down goes the Town Hall. Down goes the Tesla. Down goes the mortar. And down goes that Inferno Tower. Perfect chain of events right there for Endless. Oh, the sliver of health, I'm telling you, my queen, whenever she gets that low, has never, ever, ever, ever survived. But obviously, these Town Hall 10s are way better than me. I'm just the messenger. That's how I look at myself. Pretty sure these guys keep me around just because I do these videos. So I better continue to do these or I might be in trouble in 2.0. Anyhow, tree in the bag for Endless. Nice job, buddy. Sexy time in the city, Justin K with the six pack. All right, so four more healers on the queen. Very similar style here. Sorry, just fast forwarding that a little bit. Get her going. Boom, again, super low. When I get that low, I always hit my ability just because of my lack of luck. When I seem to drop my rage with plenty of time and she still dies, it really bugs me. Anyhow, she's going to work through this lava hound here. Already sends in his entry. Now, some guys opt for a golem. Some guys opt for giants. Again, some guys opt for a walk. Some guys opt for a charge. The amount of giants or how many Valks you take, all of that stuff is a variable. The spells are obviously a huge variable. Whether you bring a jump, you bring four earthquakes, one earthquake, even in this instance. Who knows? You bring a free spell, maybe backhand heals. All of these things are going to be base dependent. If you think you can get those Inferno Towers down fast and you can have a backhand heal for when the Inferno Towers die for the Valks, that's always a good idea. If you bring backhand hogs and you're going to heal the hogs, that's a good idea, right? So always just think of its base breakdown. Just like Town Hall 9, guys. break that stuff down, figure out exactly where you want these Valks to go. You ideally need to get them to those Inferno Towers ASAP. If you can get those Inferno Towers down, you can drop a heal, you can drop a freeze, you can drop another rage, and they're just going to continue to work through that base. So Queen's now work through that wall, going to work through all of this jazz. Valks are just shredding through this stuff. That core just disappeared instantly. Just absolutely beautiful funneling job here by Justin. Queen's going to walk around here. Valks are getting in there. Walking in another rage, going to one-shot all the rest of these defenses. Bam, 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 bam. Really has two archer towers, a cannon, and that is it. Keep in mind, level 30 king, level 34 queen, right? Nothing too crazy. Has that weird swag EQ. I don't even know why he brought it. Drop it here. Just drop it right there. Drop it. So swag poison, swag EQ. Justin K with a six-pack. Nice job, buddy. Really, really glad you're up and running at Town Hall 10. I know you're out of war for a few weeks while you're trying to get everything farmed up. So welcome back, buddy. Oh, wow. Another one. Just goes on and on and on. Okay, so very, more ring style bases. Again, so nothing special, guys. Please don't put words in my mouth. I'm not saying this is crazy. I'm just saying, it's really nice to see our Town Hall 10s really getting this stuff, really starting to have no problems whatsoever getting these three stars on Inferno bases. Like, that's really what it comes down to. Like, you're gonna run into these in a lot of random wars. So as long as you're three starring these, getting the good practice. Look at that again. Like, my queen never survives. I don't understand you guys. How do you do it? I love it. It's so awesome. So poison goes down, helping out. Hey, sorry, like I was saying, though, obviously, like, in a ranged wars, the weights are going to be matched how they're matched, and you're going to be facing equivalent Town Hall 10s or Town Hall 11s, so please, don't get me wrong, these by no means are equivalent weight bases to what we'll probably see in any sort of a ranged war, but if we're not three-starring these bases, then we got no chance of doing that in an arranged war. So, like I said, really nice to see, like, what have I shown? 4, 8, 9... I think I've shown like 10 attacks. I still have a few to go. So really, really nice job, guys. All of you. Like, I'm just really, really proud of my Town Hall 10s right now. So Giants are in. Valks are in. Same thing, right, guys? Just getting everything right in here. Now, this is a little bit of a scary moment because if I was playing this attack. Now, first of all, there's that single target Inferno. Again, we already discussed that. However, the Queen has already created the funnel on this side. So the Valks kind of go up and around, which is perfect, because some of them go down and almost create the funnel, let the majority of them jump into this core. Heal spell goes down, just gonna shred. Look how fast this stuff's going down. Town Hall is dead, like everything, boom, 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 boom. See you later, Inferno. Like, what's with the double single target Infernos? I have no idea, but oh well. So his Giant's still in there helping out. Wiz kind of doing cleanup. Queen still has a couple healers on her doing work. She's gonna do some work on this back end. Valk's bust through that wall. Just gonna rip through the rest of this stuff. Boom, boom, boom. Oop. That is tree in the bag for the Iceman. Another one, buddy. Sexy, sexy. All right. And another one. Oh, wait. Was this on my list or is this a bully? Yes, this is on my list. That's right. Eagle, 11 versus 11. I love it. Now, obviously, Guns is a max 11. Guns is a beast. Love having Guns back. He was on a bit of a break. I don't know. I get some of our 11s mixed up. Was it Guns? Oh, maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. But Guns, you're a beast. Love having you. Really just shredding through this base. The idea here now is to just kind of get up and around. He wants to pick off the Grand Warden there. Once he goes up and around, he's going to get the Grand Warden. He's going to get, get that cannon too. He just kind of gets this little corner of the base. Now, keep in mind, only has the four wall breakers here. So isn't gonna bust this queen in really anywhere. And look at this core, right? Like, this is like an island. So that's why he opted for the earthquake there, just to leave that huge open section. So what the queen now has done is created the funnel on this side of the EQ. So now what he's going to do is, I believe, go ahead and just go right in at the base from this section. Yeah, so here comes a golem and a giant out of the CC. Wall breaks in, no big deal. Boom, ba, boom. Now, Eagle Cannon starts opening up on the Golem, which turns out it's a bit of an issue, but not a huge issue. So, King goes in, funnel's created. Here comes the Valks, right? Eagle Cannon is so slow, it doesn't really help against Valkyries. So, has a bunch of his Valks sort of wander over to that King, which kind of sucks, but they still go in. Has maybe four or five there. I guess they do have a bad split. Doesn't get as much to the core as he wanted, and that balloon's in there kind of wreaking havoc, but it's just enough, right? Both Inferno Tires are down, working on those Teslas now on the outside. Queen is still walking around this base with the healers on her, just kind of doing cleanup. King's in there, sends in a few back-end hogs just to help those Valks push through this stuff. Just a sexy hit, their guns. Boom, boom, boom. Everything's blowing up, and down it goes. That's treat in the bag for guns. Nice job, buddy. Whew, I'm tired here. I think I got two more. Wait, four? What did I have four? Oh, I had three. It should be three. That's right. Okie's four. So, check out this one. Another 11 versus 11. Good old Mixa. Maybe it's Mixa that was on the break. Yeah, I don't know. Anyhow, so just going to charge on into this base, right? Very strange base layout. No buildings on the outside, so nothing. Not to worry about the funnel. Now, kind of an interesting thought with this base, because everything is so open, right? So once you send Valks in, there's not a lot of ways to plan their pathing. And that's what kind of the trick to Valkyries is. If you can plan their pathing and have them go where you want them to go, then you're probably going to be successful. However, when they start wandering and splitting and going in strange places, then there's trouble. So what Mixa does here, takes out the buildings on the right side with the little golem kind of whiz army there, takes out the other side with the queen charge, and then sends a bunch of Valks straight into that core. Oh, I got a visitor. Hi, sweetheart. You say hi?
Hi.
So, anyways, Mix is ripping through the rest of this base, right? Once you got that Valks to the core, jump to let them out the other side, right? Queen's still walking around with those healers on her, looking good, right? Really, still hasn't even touched the Grand Warden ability. Like, just shredded through this base. Like, it's all too open, right? If you are a good attacker like Mixa, and you can figure out how to just create a funnel for your Valks to walk them straight into the core, base does not stand a chance. Has a bunch of pups there doing work on the King, so that was sort of unfortunate. But the Queen is still there with the Grand Warden. Gonna finish those pups and then finish the rest of this base off. Do-do-do. A few things on the top side. Might have been really close on this, on the time on this one. I don't know. Oh, the Dark Barracks. See you later. Okay, honey, play with it out there until I'm done. I'm almost done. All right, tree in the bag for Mixa. Beautiful. All right, fly through this last one here. Oki, very nice hit. I really like this one. So another 11 versus 11. Same idea, though, right? Little queen charge with Valks. 19 Valks he's got here. So Oki's going to drop the healers, drop the queen, just kind of get some value out of this section of the base. This was literally the first of all these attacks I just watched, so I kind of forget what happens. But so charge is pretty successful. Believe wants to yank the CC out and continue the queen walking down and around this section. Got to drop that rage again. Like I never let my queen get that low. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. All right, so Queen's going to burst through this wall, actually. It's kind of strange because you think she would have went down to that army camp, but no big deal, right? Golems are in. Honey, out there, please. It's too loud. I know. Anyhow, so nowhere for the Valks to go, right? These bases with no buildings on the outside, it's just you're just setting yourself up for disaster. So he's got ton of Valks moving in now. Everything's just gonna walk right onto this base core, jump lets everything into the core. There's very few buildings really before they get in the core. Free spell down on the Eagle and the back end Inferno, just really good value on that. And just look at it disappear. That core just melted to those 20 Valks or 19 Valks, whatever you had. Queen's kind of in there now helping out. Valks have burst through now to the other side. This whole backside compartment is wide open. Still has the King ability to go. Ew. Grand Warden's in there too with a sliver of health helping out. Really, all he's got two cannons, Arch Tower, and a bunch of splash damage, which aren't going to touch the Valks or the Queen with the healers. This is definitely a tree in the bag for Oki the Great. Nice job, my friends. All right, well, as you can see, it's time for me to go. I am long overdue on this recap. This must be a super long one, but really hope you guys enjoy the attacks. You know, it's not often I get a show pretty much all, in fact, all Town Hall 11 and 10 attacks. Obviously not against the most amazing bases, but really nice to see our guys getting very successful on these practice bases. And who knows? We'll see what happens in our next arranged war. We got a big, big, big one we are searching for this afternoon. So looking forward to bringing you that one, guys. You know, we're prepping up. This is going to be a tough one for us, and we really are trying to prepare, and we really want to have a lot of successes. So that'll do it for your wisdom from Wiser. Just trying to help the bag that next tree star. Till then, I'm out.